This morning, I saw the papers which were carrying a report about the happenings in the Defence Committee of Parliament, which took place yesterday, and the way that Shri Rahul Gandhi was treated. Now, this is the second time, I have been a member of the Defence Committee of Parliament from 1980 to 84, when the Defence Minister was Mrs. Shrimati Indira Gandhi, who chaired it and who permitted everyone to speak their minds. And the second time, when I was there last, before I came into this job, when General Khanduri was the chairman. And there we had heated discussions on various issues, and he was happy to indulge everybody. I am very sad to see today that you have come to a point that the chairman of the standing committee, I don't know who this man is, but he is he's trying to control issues, make issues into non-issues. Today, the whole country is looking at the defense services and what they are facing on the Ladakh front or on the Chinese front, let me put it, or on the Pakistan front. There's not a day that passes when one or two of our men are not killed in Kashmir on the borders, or what happened with our boys when they clashed unarmed with the Chinese there. And instead of talking about strategy, and instead of talking about what you're providing them, there are equivalent of four divisions in that area. What you're giving them for living, for their clothing, for their food, for strategy, how you planned it, and matters that affect Parliament. You talk about what the uniform should be. You talk about what the buttons should be, what the badges of rank should be. I mean, is this, we are coming to a point of absurdity. This is what Rahul Gandhi meant. And when he said that, I want the larger issues to be discussed. Why? Because the Chief of Defence Staff was there. Whether the Army Chief and Navy and Air Force Chiefs were there, or their Vice Chiefs were certainly there. Somebody was there, and other people who are high up in the administration of our three services were there. So everybody wanted something to be discussed. Do you at that level discuss what the badges of rank are? I mean, everybody, for God's sake, knows what the badges of rank are. And then one person from some MP has another suggestion to make, that all the three services, Army, Navy and Air Force, should go back on the American system and have just one service. I mean, when you put people like this in defense committees who don't know the first thing about defense, it's a damn disgrace. And I'm absolutely appalled that you have somebody making suggestions like that to us in the service, who have been through the services, and like me, lakhs more who are today listening in, who have been in the services or are in the services, that you tell them that you get rid of your regimental insignias, you get rid of your regimental uniforms. What nonsense is this? What are we trying to talk about? Are we raising the morale of our forces, or are we trying to demoralize them? And here you have these people. Why can't people who come on this thing try to understand the services before talking? And what I have just mentioned, what Rahul Gandhiji said, was absolutely correct. We have to raise the level of debate. Parliament is there to make policies. Parliament is not to discuss what brasso you use to polish your buttons. And that is what I think they should understand. I mean, I've seen these defense committees working and under the senior most leaders and people you don't look at which party you belong to. Khanduri Saab belonged to the BJP. I was in the Congress. And we got on very well, and we discussed issues which were in the interest of our services. And that is the way it should have been, instead of trying to be petty on this. What is a member of the Defence Committee supposed to do? He's supposed to give his mind. He's supposed to speak. Then you don't let the member speak. What sort of a functioning is this? Now, that is because you try to politicize everything. Now, politicizing debates, politicizing committees, your External Affairs Committee or whichever committees you may be, is not the way the country runs. It has never run in this manner. For God's sake, I think the Speaker should look into this. And also, this man whoever the chairman of this committee is, he should understand that this is in the larger interest of the country what we're doing and what our members do. And I don't think he should behave in this petty manner.